Good day, everyone. So today will be our fifth week pre-recorded lesson for the second quarter. And for this week lesson, we will be discussing a drama. So are you familiar with drama? And it is written by Wilfredo Maria Guerrero, a Filipino playwright. Okay? But before that, let's find out first what is a drama and the elements of drama. Now, what is a drama? A drama is a story that is written for people to act out before an audience. And drama, also known as play, the plot is told through the words and actions of the characters. In literature, a drama is a portrayal of fictional or non-fictional events through the performance of written dialogue. It's either a prose or poetry. And drama can be performed on stage, on film, TV, or the radio. And typically, it is called plays, and their creators are known as playwrights or dramatists. And for today, we're going to discuss also the elements of drama. So here are the elements of drama. So first we have the dialogue, okay? So it is everything that characters say to one another. So when you say dialogue, these are the words that are written as speeches with the name of the character who is talking at the beginning of the line, okay? Also, it is an exchange of spoken words between two or more characters. Like for example, okay, we have here, okay, the dialogue of Kat and Alice. So, Kat, oh, you can't help that. We're all mad here. I'm mad. You're mad. And Alice, how do you know that I'm mad? Kat, you must be, or you wouldn't have to come here. All right, so that is example of dialogue, the exchange of spoken words between two or more characters. Next, we have the stage directions. So these are the playwright's notes to actors, directors, and readers printed in italic or enclosed in parentheses. So that is stage directions. So next element, we have, of course, props. Okay? These are the objects that actors need during the play. They are the items held or used by the actors on stage to make the action more realistic. And sometimes, some naturalistic performances use many props. But when staging drama, you should question what is really necessary, because too many props can be difficult for the actor to use, and they have to be brought onto and off the stage, and that it can slow the action. Okay? Those are props. Next element we have, sets or scenery. So these are the painted screens, backdrop, and other materials that help a stage look like a city, street, or woods. Also, it means the scenery and furniture on stage. And some theater sets are very elaborate and details, others are simple. All right. Okay, next element we have blocking. All right, so these are the emotions and movements of actors in a play. And in theater, blocking is the precise staging of actors in order to facilitate the performance of a play, ballet, film, or opera. Okay, so here the director usually determines blocking during rehearsal, telling the actors where they should stand for the proper dramatic effect. All right, that is blocking. Next element we have, characterization. So it is the playwright's technique of creating believable characters through dialogue, costume, and gestures. So before the dialogue in a script, The playwright will often include a cast of characters, and typically each character, both major and minor, is listed alongside a brief description of the character's role in the story. Okay, that is characterization or cast of characters. Next, we have the theme. So here it is the central message the dramatist shares with the audience, or it is the underlying idea the playwright is trying to convey to an audience. All right, so that is theme. And next we have the scenes and acts. So these are the divisions of the play, wherein scenes, known as the setting or the time of the play. In longer plays, the scenes are grouped into larger units called act. Okay, so an act, on the other hand, is a part of a play defined by elements such as rising action, climax, and resolution. So that is act. Okay, so sometimes, or rather, a scene normally represents actions happening in one place at a time and is marked off from the next scene by a curtain. Okay, or it can be a blackout or a brief emptying the stage. So those are the elements of drama. And there you go, let's discuss a drama entitled Wanted a Chaperone, a drama written and directed by Wilfredo Maria Guerrero. Okay, so this drama is a household comedy that tells about the conflicts among rich couple and their children because of their opposing views on behavior and on family norms. So the conflict here revolves on the parents' want for their children to have a chaperone. So are you ready? I know you're excited with the drama, but before that, let's meet first the author, a Filipino playwright and director, Wilfredo Maria Guerrero. Okay, so who is Wilfredo Maria Guerrero? Guerrero was born in Ermita, Manila. He wrote his first play at the age of 14, that is in Spanish. And this play was produced at Ateneo de Manila University when he was 15 years old. Okay, so he was a Filipino playwright, director, teacher, and theater artist. He wrote well over 100 plays, and 41 of which have been published. And those unpublished plays have either been broadcast over the radio or staged in various parts of the Philippines. So that is Wilfredo Maria Guerrero. So let's have the setting of the drama. So the drama happened at the living room of Don Francisco's house on the Sunday morning at 11 a.m. Okay, so here Don Francisco is one of the major characters in the play. And here are the characters of Wanted Chaperone. Okay, first we have Don Francisco, the father, Doña Petra, the mother, Roberting, their son, Nena, their daughter, Roberting, their son. Then we have Doña Dolores, okay, that is only a neighbor, and Fred, the son of Doña Dolores. We have Francisco also, that is the servant, and Pablo, also known as Paul, the mayordomo, or the head of the servant. And here are some vocabulary words or some difficult words found in the play. So some of these are Spanish words, okay? Like for example, we have diablo, that is devil. Ilustrada means educated. Muchacho, that is a servant. Que exagerada, or that is exaggerated. Ipso facto means very fact. Mayordomo, for that is boy, and mayordomo for girl, that is head of the servant. Insolently, rude, or disrespectful. And also, we have ominously, or exhibiting an omen, or something bad is going to happen. All right? So now let's discuss the plot of the story or the summary of the drama. So here is the plot of the drama or the play Wanted a Chaperone. Okay, so it is all about the traditional way of courting and accompanying girls on a party and in other occasions. So the portrayal of old customs is seen visibly in the play. And here, Don Francisco, the father of Nena and Roberting, is a strict father with his daughter Nena. Okay, he doesn't want Nena to go outside to any occasions without any chaperone. Okay, but one night Nena goes out with his, or rather with her friend Fred, and unfortunately, rumors right after their date are spread. So for rather many people think that something bad happened to the two of them. And for the townspeople, it's inevitable or it is an avoidable situation. Until one day, Doña Dolores, mother of Fred, goes to Nena's house and she is insisting that something happened to his son and to Nena. Okay, so it is also Doña Dolores' plan to insist his son, Fred, to Nena, but actually there is nothing happened between Nena and Fred. All right, so the same situation happened also to Roberting, the son of Don Francisco and the brother of Nena. So Don Francisco and Doña Dolores look for chaperones for their children to guide them instead of the muchacho. All right, so that is the plot of the drama Wanted a Chaperone. Okay. And let's have the introduction or the exposition of the drama Wanted a Chaperone. Okay, so here Roberting, the son of Don Francisco, the brother of Nena, wanted to have his old allowance, and Nena went to the party with Fred, her friend. All right, so Don Francisco here in the introduction of the drama is seen sitting on the sofa. He is about 60 years old. Okay, he is smoking a cigar and he wears a nice looking lounging room. And when Roberting entered their living room, Roberting is about 20 years old, a good looking and well-dressed son of Don Francisco. So he was thinking to ask something to his father, but he is trying to gather a lot of courage to ask. Then he finally approaches him. So Roberting wants to have his old allowance. All right, so let's have the rising action. So here, Doña Petra, the mother of Roberting and Nena, and Don Francisco are arguing whether to get Nena a muchacho. So that is a Spanish slang word for maid or a servant. Okay, so due to the gossip. So here, the couple was discussing about the party that Nena had last night. And Don Francisco was angry that Nena went to the party without a chaperone. But Doña Petra said that it is all right because Nena was with her friends at the party. But Don Francisco was being exaggerated that he can't trust Nena without a chaperone. So Don Francisco wants Nena to have a chaperone. Now let's have the climax of the drama. So here, Doña Dolores and her son Fred went to the house of Nena to talk her parent about what happened between the two last night. So what happened between Nena and his son Fred? All right, so he was asking Nena what really happened to the party with Fred last night, and Nena said nothing really happened. But Doña Dolores insists because Nena went to the party unchaperoned. So for her, it is impossible that nothing had happened. Alright, so let's have the following action of the drama. So here, Doña Dolores and his son Fred left the house of Nena after a confrontation. So Don Francisco asked Pablo, or that is Paul, the head of the servant, the mayordomo, to escort Doña Dolores and Fred to get out of their house. So there is a confrontation between the two families. And after the scene of Doña Dolores, Don Francisco started telling Doña Petra that Nena should have a chaperone. Okay? Then, Nena started to cry and admits that at the party, she had a quarrel with Fred and she left Fred at the party. Alright? So that is the following action. And let's have the resolution or the ending of the story. So Don Francisco and Doña Petra comforted Nena and told her that it will serve as a lesson to her. So next time when Nena attends a party, she should have her chaperone with her. Okay, so that's the end of the story or the play, Wanted a Chaperone. And for your ILT grade 7, please read the drama that is pages 116 to 140 of your book. And be ready for our live discussion on Wednesday. So again, this is Teacher Mitch saying, don't stop exploring and keep on learning. So bye everyone. Have a nice day.